Hello, ladies and gentlemen, we are back with more Until Dawn. Let's get back onto it. Alright, we need to venture through this door. Okay, I think I can aim here. Just need to... There we go. Protect your ears and all that. So in the last part we dealt with some doggos, but you know, it all turned out to be fine. All nice and dandy. Now let's go down these spooky looking steps. Spooky. Now we find ourselves in yet another basement, it seems. This place has a cacophony of basements. By the way, how did he lock that from the outside with the path? I'm not even going to think about it.
Of course, locked.
Well, it's a good thing that didn't have any oil in it, or else this could be a bad idea. Oh wait, it did, and that was a bad idea. Yeah, you think? And now for this. Is that a texture popping?
Hey, it's locked. The hell, who did that? And there's some serious...
We finally get to see what Matt's up to, and Emily as well. Well, this is no good. It's been a while since we've been able to control these two.
I can't believe Josh is dead.
I can't believe how he died.
No, I mean, what if they were wrong?
What?
Maybe we should have checked the shed to see if it was really true.
I don't know.
Oh, that's just crazy talk. Crazy lunacy, really?
Yeah, I guess, but some things you have to see for yourself.
I'll take your word for it. Look, an axe.
Oh, let me axe you a question.
We'll break the door down, will ya?
Whoa, wait a second. We start smashing shit down, he's gonna hear us.
Well, you got any better suggestions?
I don't know. What about... Look!
What?
A window.
The window!
Great, Matt. I can just about fit my lip balm through that little slot.
No, come on.
You will never fit through there, big guy.
You know, let's go the unpopular route. Let's go, let's be our own people.
Here goes. I'm gonna huff, and I'm gonna...
Do it!
Someone's impatient. And yoink. And here's Maddie. We are in. Oh, this place is trashed.
Got to be the guy, the one who...
The guy? You mean the mascot for Disturbed?
Only way back.
Don't say that.
Look, the cable car's all the way out there.
Well, that's not far, right? You can jump it?
I'm good, Em. But not that good. Flattered, though.
Well, Matt, if you can't jump that, what are we gonna do?
Well, you're being quite helpful. Suppose one thing we can do is just venture around, find some clues, and all that.
Exactly what they were doing.
Idea!
Hey, look! Fire tower.
Hey, Magellan, maybe we should get the cable car working and take this show on the road, huh?
She is clearly not getting it.
Friendly.
Unfollow.
Boo! Ooh, that was terrible. That was just bad. That was bad, okay. Looks like we don't have a key.
No keys, no cable car. So, back to square one.
What about the fire tower on the map you found?
That's me smacking my forehead. Ugh.
Probably, yeah.
Matt, we gotta get to that radio!
We can use the radio to call for help. Somebody's gotta pick up the signal.
Oh, well, someone's learning to play by the rules.
What rules?
Rule number one, Emily is always right.
Yeah.
Nothing else matters because Emily is always right.
Let's just continue. Let's just continue. Let's just continue.
Oh, hold up.
Oh, what now?
What's cooking? Good looking.
Getting us out of here, Mr. Meat for Brains.
Well, at least he has some sort of brains. Just waiting and waiting and waiting for the animation to end. Slowly. Yeah, if you want to go out the most convoluted way possible, but oh well.
You all right?
Don't
Thank
worry,
goodness.
I am the Quick Time King.
You go first to protect me.
Now I'm getting Claptrap flashbacks. Protect me, Squire!
Oh my gosh.
Almost. Almost.
I'm feeling kind of
Don't
faint.
look down.
Now I got Linkin Park in my head. Not that it would be a bad thing for that to happen. Also, I just noticed that Matt here is wearing sweatpants. Those are totally sweatpants. Suppose it fits the weather though, but still, I can't believe I just noticed that now. I'd prefer thick denim jeans, personally, but hey, to each their own.
Maybe we can just climb down.
Climb down what?
The mountain.
Are you serious?
What's the big deal? It's not like it's floating in the sky.
Although it certainly feels like it.
Pitch black out.
Hey, hopefully we won't have to.
You think the psychopath is just gonna give up and run away?
No.
You don't know.
Maybe we should find a safe spot. Hold up, wait it out. It'll be a lot easier to figure this all out in the morning.
As long as we don't hide in the lodge, that's where he expects us to go.
Well, at least she's a little genre savvy. Walking, 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 walking in the snow. Walking, 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 we know just where to go. That is a totem. We don't need that. We are not about that life. All right. Oh, I remember this part. I believe we're about to have ourselves a little cliffhanger here. Dan Cliff.
Yes, Matt. Given the choice, I'd prefer not to spend my evening plummeting to my death off a snowy clifftop.
I think we all know a Dan Cliff, some time in our lives. Either in the future, in the past, in the present, there's always a Dan Cliff. Dan Cliff is everywhere. And Dan Cliff knows all. Because Dan Cliff is always watching. Alright, it seems we have ourselves in quite the pickle. Alright, we're gonna go back to the psychiatrist's office. Or not. Fan service! Or disservice because of the creepiness. That is just beyond creepy. Well, yeah, that's one thing that's happening.
Okay.
Also, props to the game's directors for having at least some restraint. Extremely not cool.
Chris? Josh? What the hell?
The balloon is telling us to go this way. Oh. That was a bit louder than I was expecting.
Chris?
And now I have It Is the End by Ice Nine Kills in my head.
This is really getting out of hand, okay? It was all very funny.
Alright, now you said out of hand. Now the song's definitely in my hand. It's in my head. It's now officially in my head.
Alright? You had enough?
We all float down here. We all, it is the end. I have a terrible singing voice.
You succeeded.
All right, we should coming up on a cutscene. All right, you then. Now we have a flashlight, so we can batter people to death with it. Remember, anything and everything can be used as a weapon.
This is weird. Hey! Guys, come on! Oh, I'm done with this! I really don't appreciate the silent treatment here!
Well, that's spooky.
Hello, Samantha. Looking for me? I don't think you'll have much luck by looking, Samantha. You're only going to see what I want you to see. And I have quite a lot to show you.
What is going on?
Open your eyes.
Oh my God.
She's quite beautiful, isn't she?
What are you doing out there?
A beautiful bathing bird. Do you think she has any idea what lies ahead?
That is beyond creepy, really. That is just a whole another level.
Life.
Showing this to me.
Why are you watching?
Josh!
How does it make you feel?
Oh my God, what did you do?
I'm going to give you 10 seconds.
Well then, that's not a lot. Yeah, we are going to run.
Shit.
All right, quick time, King. Don't fail me now. Yeah, hiding's not going to do us very much good, really. Gotta think fast. Yeah! Gotta focus.
Oh
Just keep going, just keep going.
Are you kidding me? No handle?
There we go. We got the handle. There we go.
Get out!
Bam! All right. Now that that is over with, we can actually get a Mojang, maybe. Ouchies! Oh, that is looking very unpleasant. And we're walking, and we're walking.
Oh, fuck.
Fuck. Hopefully I chose the right decision. Quick time king, baby!
Here, baby kitty. Here, pussy pussy.
All right. I did the thing.
Fuck.
Ha ha! I never passed that before. So there's a first time for everything. And hello, Mr. Peter Stormare.
According to plan, now did it. Such careful, brilliant plotting, and yet in a crucial moment you are foiled by your own inadequacies. I told you. Everything you do has consequences. You think
you and your overacting.
What you do, what you say, causes things to change.
Well, obviously. Unless time really is just one linear line that we have no choice in, and everything that we perceive as choice is nothing more than an illusion of our minds.
Turned it against these people who you so desperately want to torment. Has it been worth it?
Well, I guess it's all just a matter of perspective, really. Oh yes, I remember that photo. Oh, that is just moderately disturbing.
Ah! Stop it! You can't do this! Please!
Oh!
Here.
I don't understand what happened.
There's a maniac.
This is insane.
Is the maniac on the floor?
Hello? Guys?
Hello, Samantha. Looking for me?
We should look for the others.
Mike and Jess are off 69ing each other, and who knows where Sam is.
I think she's in the lodge.
Why are we still talking about this? Let's go.
Hey, look. Fire tower.
You know, I've always wanted to play Firewatch. Just never got around to doing it. Although I have seen a couple of Let's Plays and reviews. It looks super fun. You know, just guess seems like a summer game, and summer's too far away. So I guess maybe I'll buy it sometime in the future. All right. Seek.
What are you going to do?
Chapter 6, Seek Osis, 5 hours until dawn. Let's stay calm.
Stay calm. Relax. They're just deer.
Oh, dear indeed.
No, Matt. They're gonna hurt us.
It is kind of creepy how all these deer just decide to corner us here, and now they're all just backing away. They're all just backing away. Parting of the deers. I guess that'll make Matt the Moses of this group. Move along.
Oh,
See, it's all groovy. Now we get to be Emily. Hooray! Which we will do in the next part. Thank you for joining me for this. Quit the exciting little chase there. And once again, I prove that I am the Quick Time King! Bye-bye!